Alright, welcome, or should I say, velkomnir, or something like that, which was my, if somebody from Iceland is watching this, feel free to kill me if you see me in real life, because I'm gonna butcher Icelandic. Anyway, welcome to part one of our new exciting Let's Play from Crusader Kings 2, of the House Raven, or Raven House, I think is what Raven means. We have Ragnar, who is, with a collar and everything. Yeah, he's dressed up, cleaned up nicely, my friend. He is Ragnar, that's Ragnar with two R's to you. He is a fortune builder, he's good with money. He's a kinslayer, because he has some of the same backstory as the old last guy. He's a legitimized bastard, he's a genius, he's lustful, he's cynical, he's patient, and he happens to be wounded after killing his father. Now, his heir is some idiot from Trunda, so we're not going to care about him. And he is the current de facto ruler of Trøndelag. Yes, Trøndelag, glorious Trøndelag. We've been here before. Actually, last time we started, we ruled the Duchy of Trøndelag, but we didn't hold the County of Trøndelag. We held the County of Naumdal, which is a nice Hedmark, Oppland, Akershus, Vestfold. This is where I am in real life, right about. Yeah, there. Yeah, that's my house. Wow, they modeled my house. I'm impressed by that. So, thank you, Paradox. It's because of my immensely popular YouTube channel. No, no. Yeah, that must be the reason why. Anyway, right now we are in Trondheim, which is supposed to be here, I think. Akershus is the county capital of Trondheim, was it? No. Audunborg, yep. And we have the city of Trondheim, Temple of Nidaros, and the Barony of Stenekil. In real life, these two are on the same, in the same place. Really sure why they do it like that. Anyway, the world is our oyster, as you'd expect. So, this is my absolute first time sitting down with this DLC, and I have no idea what to do. So let's just pretend this is normal playthrough. We'll have a look. Ragnar of Trøndelag, yep, County of Trøndelag, and it is land succession, agnatic gavelkind, that's shite. The jure size of it is the same as yep, brilliant, and it's part of the Duchy of Trøndelag, part of the Kingdom of Norway and the Empire of Scandinavia, which looks a bit like that. Which is very similar to what it looked like in previous incarnations of the game. That looks fine. So, Kingdom of Norway, first things first. Looks a lot like it does today, except today we don't have these islands. Which island is this? I don't know. Yep, we don't have these and we don't have Iceland. Other than that, Norway is pretty much what it looks like in this version of the game. Except, of course, Jämtland and Härjedalen. Damn you, Sweden. Give us back Jämtland and Härjedalen. I'm sort of obliged to say that. These parts aren't filled with Norse, I think. Well, yes, they are. That's Norse, and that's Sumensko. Is that it? Sumensko. My Sami is very poor, but do my best not to butcher it completely. Anyway. As I was saying, I'm the County of Trøndelag, and I can go for the Duchy of Trøndelag, which is probably what I'm going to do at first. Ooh, they changed it. This used to be a de jure part of the Duchy of Trøndelag. It's not anymore. It's part of Ostlanda. That makes more sense, actually. Okay, fine. So I think our first order of business would be to establish the Duchy of Trøndelag. Yep, I think that would be cool. So that would mean taking on this guy. And just a clear warning. Ah. Well. There you go then. Pagans are allowed to subjugate other pagan rulers once in their lifetime. With the Become King ambition, there is no such time limit against targets within the kingdom. Free men are always willing to follow the majestic ruler. The mightiest ruler, okay. So I can do this once before I get the ambition to become king. Cool. I'll have the ambition to get married, thank you very much. Somehow, I think I'll be able to do that. Until the game. I'm no heir. I will lose all my titles on succession. And my ruler is unmarried. I like these new icons, they're cool. Well, Namdal will be my first priority. This looks bigger than it was. Wasn't it split in two in the old version of it? Yeah. It is split in two, dumbass. Just ruled by the same guy. Okay. Slana seems to be... Oh, yeah. This is a king of a petty kingdom of Slana. You're gonna have to pay. I just... Yeah. That's not gonna be too bright, is it? Let's see, what kind of army you got? You have... 724 troops. I kind of forget. I've been playing the other game so long. I got 333. That's not exactly a rousing army, is it? Okay, so first order of business is get more money. How many men you got? 618. I'm going to be lucky if he doesn't subjugate me. Any reason to declare war on you? No. Impiety. Okay. So, fabricate some claims or something? I don't know. First things first, let's get married. Other things first. Fabricate me a claim. First off, are you the best man for the job? Wow, you are by far. So. How do we get there or there? Let's... Before we do anything stupid. And remember, I have not played... Yes. So we definitely want to fabricate there. I can do the subjugation thing up here. Then... Okay, here's the plan. Here we go. Hold on, because this is going to be awesome. We fabricate a claim on this. Attack. And I don't know. Capture. That'll be fine. Hopefully he does not have too many allies. He has no allies, so that'll be fine. He has... Wow. He has no family either. He is Fuked, just like me. And he has a son. Okay, good for him. So, we need to invade him. Once we've done that, we hopefully have enough money and gold and stuff and things for mercenaries, so we'll do the subjugation attack there, and then we'll declare our intent to become king, and hopefully with these four providence we have enough to take on Uppland with mercenaries, and Bob's your uncle. So that's the plan. You. Yeah, you can probably... What should you be doing? Levy size plus 27%, that's tempting. Military technology. I want military technology because of the new patch and everything. I want. Ooh, look at you! Look at you with your helmet and your axe and everything. Wow, you really look the martial type, don't you, Stuart? Local build time, tax modifier 25%, or technology. 25% of. Bubkus is pretty close to Bubkus, if I'm not mistaken. I think that's how the math works out. Yeah, that'll give me another gold a year, which is absolutely terrible. So... Of course, the chance of getting a special tithe collected is good. It's 3% early, yearly, though, so relying on it is just not that good. So we'll do the tech thing. You! You the best one for the job? Yes, you are. My god, that's abysmal. You, Spymaster Odr of Trøndelag. Yep. Who are these guys anyway? You seem to be my Baron. Okay, cool. You're 6 years old. We're about the same age. We're unattached, so we're probably not friends, no. Well, I kinda like him, he does not kinda like me. So I think he's dependable, he thinks I'm twat. Fine. So is my marshal, as he has a ward. Lucky him. He's lowborn. Was this guy lowborn? No, he's standing home. That's a proper place. That's actually where that baron is. That place even exists today. Okay, he is. He has a ward, but other than that, he is also totally unattached and my age. And I think he's a bit of. He thinks I'm a bit of a twat, or he knows I'm a twat, and I don't necessarily like him that well either. But Marshall, he doesn't have to like me. Suck it. This guy, on the other hand, that's a problem. Now the steward, he is. He's the senior of our little. And the brothers here. And he's content, he doesn't give a damn. Eh. Oh, and he's my namesake. Ragnar, Midragnar, Ragnar, Ragnar, yeah. He even spells it with two R's, because that's awesome. Now, so whose opinion is, whose, this is... Yeah, he likes me 38, I like him 30, so he likes me more than I like him. That's fine. Now my spymaster, who are you? Yet another one of the... Oh, he's ambitious. Oh, that's glorious. Let me guess. Huh? Minus 45 for short range. Oh my god. Or, Odin. Oy vey. No, that's... that's Jewish. sorry about that. Okay. Plot discovery chance plus 16. Spy network assassination chance plus 8. Do I have to send him off quickly to study technology? No, I'm gonna have him scheme. Although that is actually fairly pointless, but nah. And then my seer. Who are you? Again, one of these lowborn. Bull! He really isn't nobody, isn't he? Why don't you like me? Wow, the penalty is harsh. So he can convert people, but that doesn't make any sense because they're already converted. He can research cultural tech, which is cool, or he can improve religious relations. And I think, how do you? That would be talking to himself, then, wouldn't it? So we're gonna go for the cultural tech thing, because there is no other person to give life to. Oh, holy sites. Yeah, so three of them are under control of the Norse, and... What the hell is that? Well, that's gonna be easy. That's gonna be easier, but seriously, this is Norse holy site? Oh my god. Is it that one? It wasn't even that one, is that? It's this one. Okay, then I guess we know what we have to do. The Fylkirata? Your vassals. Okay. I'm assuming this is like the papacy for us heathens. Us Norsemen, we're not heathens. Those other people are heathens. It works, isn't it? Everybody else is a heathen. Who the hell are you? Alright, that's my chancellor, and you're fabricating a claim. That's fine. Modify to old using control by this religion. Levy size plus 30%, retinue size plus 50%. That's cool. I like the plus retinue size. That might actually help a little bit. So that is, yeah, you like me enough. Oh, no, you're some other guy. Okay. That's my bishop, or my... My goody? Really? My goody? It's hilarious. So what you're gonna do? You're gonna take care of the cultural tech thing. There you go. There's my motley crew. Looks slightly effeminate there. You have... Are you sure you are... Yeah, you're wearing a dress, you're wearing your hair long, and you've shaved your beard for this group photo, so I'm kind of suspicious of you. Strange feeling you might be an imposter, but I'll let it pass. I'll let it pass for now. Okay, change my succession laws. That's not gonna happen until I reform my religion, isn't it? Yes. Brilliant. Feudal taxation, none. Feudal levies. Tempting to bump it up to max, but hang on. That would be mean bringing him down to not liking me at all, but I can do that later, but I probably will bump that up because I need more of a levy. Technology, this is interesting. So shipbuilding, I'm good at... What the hell does shipbuilding do? Galleys plus 20%. That's 20% what? Number? I'm gonna go ahead and assume that. And I get better shipyards? Okay, fine, cool. The rest of this I have no way of doing anything. And I... You don't do this anymore. I can look at where... Okay, where the technology is good. So yeah. Not much to do here, except hope that we will get more technology after a while. Retinue size. Ooh, I can have 36 men! I'm gonna run off and not recruit that. Yeah. Levies. My vassal will give me actually 31 men. It says 32. But I'm gonna go right ahead and assume somebody's not gonna show up. So that's cool. Raise county levels. Raise vassal levies. Okay. Gonna have to... They look very much the same right now, but... Maybe... This raises them all split? This raises them in their capital? I don't know. Anyway, my personal army is, of course, slightly larger. If I wanted to be an asshole... I could revoke all the titles right now and take them for myself. And I would probably win any attempted resistance. Should we do that? Well, maybe I'll think about it. In the meanwhile, three vassals. There's some mercenaries. 70, 75, okay, they haven't changed. Good. Holy orders, none, and they'll hopefully stay like that. So, intrigue. No threats, no prisoners, no known plots. Fine. What can we do here, then? Invite holy man to court. Cost me piety. Give me a priest. I've got 10 piety to spare. 1 gold for a noble. 1 gold for a... Or lady, you can go on a grand hunt for 1 gold in September. I have to heal up first. I can commission a runestone, cost me 100, and I can hold the great bloat. And I can do that now. Before March, month is at least November. Okay, so I can do that during the winter, that makes sense. Winter bloat. Well, I don't think we'll be bloating anytime soon. really sure. Once every 9 years. Okay, I should have. I think I should have a prisoner before I do this. So factions, no factions to report. And yeah, that was the religion bit of it. So here we go. Here's the castle shipyard, which is the only thing that's been built, and that's plus 4 galleys. Where's the one that gives the menace? There's the one that gives the menace. Plus 2. Okay, so I can build that. I have to have city wall, the castle walls level 2 before I can build a house, Carl training ground. Other than that, these look very similar, don't they? Keep pressing castle fortification. Yep. Barony, let's take a look here. Yes, this all seems fine. Okay then, let's have a quick look at the diplomatic relations. This guy has nothing. Okay, he has nothing. Okay, there are not really any diplomatic relations to speak of. Religions, why is this so right? Is it a holy site? Yes, it's a holy site. Cool. That's a good way of seeing those. Hey, that's Norse. Cool. Jurvik, of course. Culturally, yeah, we're all Norse, and then there's Lapish and the Finnish. Pomeranians, Germans, Dutch, Frankish. Anglo-Saxon. Oh, cool. They're Anglo-Saxons. Norse in there. A little bit of Norse in Ireland. Ireland. And of course Iceland's Norse. Okay. Well, this is changing. Italian. Egyptian. No Romans anymore. Fair enough. Economy. Not actually the poorest of the Norse holdings. Actually, that's not bad news. Maybe I can work with this. Jure duchies. Yes, we want that duchy. Hope he doesn't form it. Does he? No, he does not have. It's 2 out of 5, and I have 1 out of 5. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Kingdom, blah, blah, blah. Empire, blah, blah, blah. Revolt risk, nothing. Dynasties, yeah, whatever. Opinions. Facts may change, but my opinion never does, no matter what the facts are. So there. Earth vassals, nobody cares. Trading houses, okay, I wish I could see where that other trade republic was, but I'll figure that out eventually. The ledger has absolutely nothing of interest for me right now. Go to home providence, yep. Entitled, find the address. Okay, all the other things seem like they were. So, on that bombshell, I think I'll end the first episode. I haven't done anything. Don't you worry. He's right at my... Who are you? What are you doing in my court? Just some guy named Bob. Okay, cool. Center scheme, research, yep. So yeah, on that bombshell, didn't do anything interesting. I'm gonna end the episode, and then we're gonna get cracking with some raiding and wars and pillaging and you know, all that good stuff. All that sweet Norse good stuff. So thanks for watching, and see you around. Cheers.